So let's talk about postmenopausal estrogen. Now, before you go through menopause, roughly about age 50, 52, the ovaries are working and they're producing estrogen. But after your ovaries go into retirement, when you're in menopause, postmenopausal, you're going to be getting your estrogen from other places, not necessarily the ovaries. And the biggest place you're going to get it from is from your fat cell. Now, if you have a lot of fat on your body, then you're going to actually start making excess amounts of estrogen. You're also going to convert some of your adrenal hormones into estrogen as well, but it's not as much as your fat. Unless you don't have a lot of fat, then you'll probably be in better shape. But if you have excess amounts of fat in your body, chances are you're going to convert that into estrogen. And there's an enzyme that helps with that. And this is one of the reasons why women end up with estrogen dominance after menopause and they have all these issues, whether it's cancer, hot flashes, night sweats, vaginal dryness, lowered mood, depression, irritability, all these different things. Not to mention if you have a fatty liver, which a lot of women do have, you're not going to be able to clear out estrogen properly and estrogen will build up even more. So you end up with this situation where you have way too much estrogen. And now that estrogen can also put on more fat, and you're kind of stuck between a rock and a hard place. And there's three types of estrogen: estrone, estradiol, and estriol, okay? Estriol happens pretty much only when you're pregnant, so we're not gonna talk about that. Estrone and estradiol are the biological active form of estrogen. And this one is produced by the adrenal. Your adrenals are being converted to estrogen through an enzyme called aromatase. And then you have estradiol that is made from the ovary, your own fat, or the adrenal hormones. So what can you do? Well, one of the things you could do is you can actually take a natural aromatase inhibitor, okay? And I listed 8 of them right here. If you consume some of these, what that will do, that will inhibit this conversion, and you'll make less estrogen. And of course, it's a given that I'm always gonna recommend the healthy keto eating plan as well as intermittent fasting. And if you're new to my channel, I put a link down below. But for most of you that know about my videos, you've heard me say this a million times. You wanna get on that plan, especially if you're going through menopause. Okay, number one, the white button mushroom, okay? That is a legitimate aromatase inhibitor. Then we get stinging nettle root, okay? I love this herb because it will also reduce inflammation greatly, and it's really good for the liver. Grape seed extract is another one. Maca, okay? This has a lot of nutrition as well. It's the maca tree, it's a certain leaf, so it will give you additional properties. And then we have quercetin, which is an anti-inflammatory. It's also good for sinus allergies and allergies in general, but it can also help regulate estrogen. Licorice root is another one that will help you support healthy estrogen levels. Then we got another thing called genistein, which is extract from soy, which I usually never recommend, but in this case, if you're getting an organic source, it's a property that will help you stop making so much estrogen. Okay, and then DIM, which is a concentrated cruciferous vegetable blend that will also help to regulate the amount of estrogen you're making. Now, if you haven't seen my other videos on menopause, check them out. I put them up right here.